Hey Design Nation, today you're going to learn the quickest way to keep your SketchUp file sizes down. So I'm going to teach you how to keep your file sizes down. And I'm going to basically start by introducing you to the 3D Warehouse if you're not already aware. So if you go to Window, Components, you can type in anything you want. So I'm going to type in Hunger Games, and it's going to search the 3D Warehouse, which is basically where you can upload, anyone can upload models that they've made and share them. So I'm going to scroll down, and I'm going to select this model here to import into my project. It's going to download, I'm going to click here, and it's going to import into my project. One thing that is nice is that you can click on this link instead of clicking on the image. If you click on the image, it will download into your project. If you click on the link, it'll open up this window. What's nice is that you can now see the SketchUp file size, so you want to make sure that the models that you're downloading, are their size is justified for sort of what you're getting. So 6.1 megabytes is okay. It's not great. And I'm going to show you sort of what to watch out for when you're downloading from the 3D Warehouse, because it's inherently, although it's great to be able to share models, it's also sort of unfortunate that not everyone knows the best practices to SketchUp, so you're bound to get sort of a lot of mistakes in modeling that can really bog down your model if you're not careful. So here is the Hall of Justice from Hunger Games, and you can see first off that there is a huge box. I'll get to that a little bit later. I want to run you through different statistics on this this model. So if you go to Window and hit Model Info, down at this tab, you can see that for my entire file, it has different items and a count. So it has component definitions 10, materials 55, and I'll get to this a little later, but basically I want to save this. I'm going to save this to a file. I'm going to call it the Hall of Justice. Now that it's saved, I'm going to pull this up, and you can see the file size is essentially the same that it was when I clicked this link. So 6.1 and 6.3. So it's good. It's not 100% accurate, but it's close. So if you look, these two buttons, if you're having problems with your SketchUp crashing or it's really difficult to move around and navigate through your model, I recommend opening this and coming to this and seeing what these numbers look like, and then clicking these two buttons. So if you click Purge Unused, you'll see that our numbers jump down. This was 10 and this was 55, and now those numbers got smaller. And then hit Fix Problems, and that's gonna, so this is fine. But that's just a good thing to run. And essentially what Purge Unused did was anything that isn't actually active in the model is going to delete. SketchUp won't delete anything from your model until you do this. So any components that you have used at one point or another and maybe deleted in the screen but didn't purge, it's going to be in the file. So that's really going to bog down your file size. So whenever you can, purge and hit fix problems. So I'm going to save this, and we're going to check out the file size and see if it got any smaller. So it did. It went from 6,000 to about 3,000. So it's about half the size. So that's just really good thing to keep in mind, is that this straight from the 3D Warehouse can be improved by just doing, you know, purging and fixing problems. The other thing that I wanted to get to is that you can see that this box is humongous. And it doesn't look like there's anything in here, so if I click, you know, I can't find anything that's going on in here. But if you hit view and go to hidden geometry, you'll see there's all these little things sort of happening in the background that the author didn't really pay any attention to. So you can delete those, and that's going to save on file size as well. You can see up here. So I just want to sort of make the point that if you're importing stuff from the 3D warehouse, I fully support that, but you want to make sure you're cleaning up your models to save on your file space. So if at any time during this video you've been watching and you're thinking, hey, I don't think I want to spend the time to clean up these models, we felt the same way. So what we've done at Designer Hacks is we've started to compile a library of components that we've sifted through and cleaned up and brought down their file size so that you don't have to do that work, that you can sort of go through our library and find what's good for you and sort of what you want. So if you head on over to designerhacks.com/components, you can find our growing library there. And until next time, happy hacking. So you click on this. This is probably way fancier than you need. This is just sort of showcasing what dynamic components can do. So this pops up these little spheres, and you can click on them and it'll change.